that transfer, aren't they? 5,000 light years from Berlin, and I'm still feeling the spirit. We gotta have them on. All right. Our first guest shot to stardom in her Emmy Award-winning role on the series ER in her new film, The Newton Boys. It opens on Friday. Please welcome the very talented and beautiful Julianna Margulies.
Just fine.
Good to see you.
It's nice to be back in New York with you. I don't like you out in LA. I mean, I like you, but yeah. It doesn't feel right.
It's not normal, is
no.
it? Thanks yeah. for coming and doing the show while we were there.
It was a pleasure.
But it was a difficult thing for us because we had like an 800-foot ceiling.
I know, this is more cozy and intimate and...
We're home now.
New York.
There's no place like home, Julia. Did you grow up in New York? No.
Yeah, well,
you did?
Semi. I was born in Spring Valley, New York.
Spring Valley, where's that?
Rockland County.
Rockland County, you mean Spring Valley? That's where I go to the movie theater.
Are you serious?
I'm not kidding.
That's where I grew up. Well, it's where I was born, up until I was like 5.
So you never saw the new movie theater there?
I didn't.
It's lovely. They got the soft pretzels. You ever go to the movie theater with those?
With the cheese on them?
Yeah. You don't enjoy those?
I've never had them, no.
Real? What do you get at the movie theater when you go?
I like hot tamales or junior mints or M&Ms. That's my thing. Hmm.
Never popcorn with the candy in it? Never do that? Then when you get a handful, it's a surprise.
But then the M&Ms melt and it's all melty and I kind of like clean.
Bring a baby wipe. You bring a baby wipe, you can have all the enjoyment and the cleanliness. It's nice. You go to the movies a lot?
I do, as much as I can.
I do too, yeah. I saw your new movie, The Newton Boys.
You saw it?
They sent me a tape. It's a great movie.
Oh, yeah, it's a lot of fun.
You and those four cutie patootie guys,
too. I know, huh?
That Matthew McConaughey, is he as nice as he seems?
Yeah, he's a doll.
He's coming on the show on the 23rd.
He is?
Yeah.
He's a doll. It's,
yeah.
You know, it's a tough life getting paid to do what I do.
Yeah, to get to be his girlfriend. Got to make out with him and everything.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, a little bathtub scene. It was a lot of fun.
We got that scene.
You do.
We got the scene in the bathtub.
You know, I keep saying, can we show the dramatic scene? I was like, no, the bathroom scene.
Yeah.
Like, great.
We enjoyed the bathtub scene. Want to see it right now?
Sure.
We have. Let's take a look. The Newton Boys, take a look at Julianna Margulies with Matthew McConaughey, Nudie Patootie in the bath. Woo.
Six bandits got away with an estimated $200,000.
Hell, maybe 80. Them damn Canucks are pencil-whipping the insurance companies just like back home. You tell me, Lou, who's the criminals here?
They are believed to be American citizens, one of which is thought to be critically wounded. Police are combing the hospitals and doctor's offices, hoping to find a trail of blood that will lead them to the perpetrators of this shocking crime.
Wouldn't have been no shocking crime if they'd just dropped them bags like a regular person. Now, Lou, you're coming at me, right? You got a bag, out of nowhere comes a gun, what do you do? Boom, drop the bag, I pick it up, I'm gone. How hard is that? Damn.
Willis.
Mm-hmm.
You have to promise me this was the last bank robbery.
Damn right it was the last bank robbery. Because from now on, it's the whole business, and that's it.
So with bank robbers, a true story.
A true story.
And it opens next Friday, The Newton Boys. When did you do it?
In my hiatus last year.
You did?
Well, July. We finished in July.
And was it the full time of your vacation?
April, May, June, and July, yeah.
Wow, that's got to be tough, huh? So you didn't get a break at all?
No, well, for me, it wasn't so bad because all my scenes are with Matthew. So all the bank robbing scenes, I would have like a week off here and there and
right.
I'd be able to relax. It was actually a perfect shoot for me.
Yeah.
It was a lot of fun. Got to wear great clothes.
And you have another movie coming out too, don't you?
I do, with Renee Zellweger. I play her sister-in-law. I play a Hasidic Jew. I've got a shadel.
Really?
Yes, do you know what a shadel is?
I know Shayna. It's a wig, Shayna.
It's a wig.
Right? Yeah,
it's a wig that the women wear when, after you're married, you're not supposed to be attracted to the opposite sex, and they
right.
shave their heads and wear a shadel.
There was only one movie about Hasidic Jews, and that was that Melanie Griffith movie.
Yeah.
Remember that?
Yeah.
It was funny. She was like, I don't understand. We can't put the deli with the meat in the refrigerator.
Do you know what's so funny is what? I met Sidney Lumet for that movie 5 times before,
really?
When I still lived in Brooklyn. And, oh, yeah, I wanted that movie more than anything.
Well, I think, so you know, you with the dark hair and the dark, you would have fit in more. Melly Grimm with the blonde hair. I don't understand about Judaism. I love her. She sounds like Minnie Mouse on helium, doesn't she?
My favorite is...
I've got a head for business and a bot for sin.
Yeah.
That's
she
my
does,
favorite line.
She?
Yeah.
Working girl.
What's the part in there? You play...
So I play Renee Zellweger's sister-in-law.
Yeah.
My younger brother's married to her. My older brother's stupping her. Can you say that on TV?
I think you can. You just did. It's a live show. Stupping. There you go.
And I'm sort of a much smaller part than in the Newton Boys, but it's a great... I feel like I'm the comedic relief in this movie just because I look like Annette Funicello in my wig.
Really? Do you get to see any Mickey Mouse thing?
Well, the first day on the set, I literally walked right past the director and I went, morning, and he didn't say anything back. And I went, nice, first day, you know.
Yeah.
And then they said, okay, everyone get on the set, and he's looking for me. And I'm right in front of him, and I realize no one knows it's me.
Yeah.
And people have watched the whole movie not realizing it's me, because the credits are at the end.
Really?
Yeah, because I look like Annette Funicello.
So you don't, basically, you don't look like this, your new ads for Emmanuel? Hello? Can we say, wow, what is that? Sexy. Now, you look pretty sexy in these.
Well,
and there's a huge billboard, which I believe will be causing a lot of accidents.
Oh, that's the... Well, that was very... I heard my publicist called me up. She goes, you have a billboard. It's on Sunset. Drive to work on Sunset. Because I usually drive freeway. So, okay. So I'm driving, and I see it. And I'm at a stop sign, and I'm looking at it. And I look over, and the guys in the car next to me are looking at me. I've never been so embarrassed, so I don't drive by it anymore.
Yeah, that's bad.
It was so narcissistic.
Being the tabloid story. Julianna Margulies, narcissist! Now, part of the proceeds for this, Emmanuel, which is a clothing line, right?
It's a beautiful clothes, yeah.
Yeah, part of the proceeds are going to charity?
They go to, I'm on an AIDS foundation called Love Heals, which is the Allie Gertz Foundation.
Right.
She was a girl who died of AIDS I don't remember the year, 87, I think, or 88. And it's to help women and children and help educate children about AIDS. And so part of the proceeds go to that, which is one of the reasons
I did
Well,
that's really wonderful, isn't it?
Companies
are getting that now.
Yeah.
Corporations are kind of getting a little more conscious about that.
And these guys are incredibly generous. They're very, politically correct, and they understand, you know?
Yeah.
So it meant a lot.
Now, in this one right here, no bra, obviously. And here at the SAG Awards, I believe, was the Golden Globes. Again, the no bra thing going on. And I read in this magazine that Julianna Margulies leaves most of her jewelry and under things at home. I'm quoting from people.
But, you know, they ask you, they corner you at the SAG Awards. It was right afterwards, and he says, so what do you wear under a dress like that? And I just, well, actually nothing, because you'd see, you know, these little dresses, you can't.
Sure.
You'll see panty lines.
Yeah.
And then, you know, now it's in that. I mean, they just exaggerate.
Sure. But you were, in fact, a nudie patootie there. You had a little sequin on and pretty much nothing else.
Well, yeah. You know, speaking of underwear, actually, the last time I was on, we had a little boxer short bonding moment.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And it's her birthday on Saturday. So anyway, so I bought you some boxers for your birthday.
You did?
I did. Happy birthday, boxers.
Oh, how cute are those? Look, a little happy birthday boxer.
And then Calvin Klein was so taken by us that we were talking about boxers, they made you your own boxers. These are made.
Oh, Calvin Klein, isn't that nice for me for my birthday? You'll be happy to know I've been doing the exercise bike.
You have?
27 minutes for the last 13 days.
Congratulations.
And I'll be wearing these. Do you do the bike?
I hate the bike.
What do you do, Stamets?
It's called the transporter. It's like a bike running machine.
And then in the middle you go, beam me up, Scotty.
Kinda. And the treadmill.
The treadmill. Well, I'll be thinking of you as I'm wearing these, doing them on my birthday. It's delightful to see you as usual.
Thank you.
The movie opens next Friday, The Newton Boys. It's a great film, and you're fabulous in it. And I'll be looking for you on Sunset.
Thank you.
Julianna, thanks for being here. We'll be right back.